Well, some of the most vulnerable people in the world are facing another brutal blow. Rohingya refugees in Bangladesh desperately need warm clothes, blankets and stronger shelters to protect them from cold winter conditions. It has been 4 months since violence escalated in Myanmar's Rakhine state, forcing more than 600,000 Rohingya to flee across the border to Bangladesh. Most of them are now living in overcrowded refugee camps. They're sleeping on the floors of flimsy makeshift shelters. Some have thin blankets. Many others have absolutely nothing to keep themselves warm at night. The aid group Save the Children says kids are running around in bare feet, wearing only shorts and t-shirts. And many of those same children are malnourished, putting them at even more risk of getting sick as this cold weather moves in. Well, let's bring in Beatrice Ochoa. She is the advocacy manager with Save the Children. Thank you so much for being with us. As these conditions steadily worsen for these children in these camps, what are they telling you about what they're going through?
Thanks so much for the invite. Yeah, children are telling Save the Children that they are incredibly cold at night. You might not think that there's actually winter in Bangladesh, but it can actually get quite chilly. So they are telling us that when they are sleeping, they are shaking. When they are waking up in the morning, they have to go fetch water, they have to go and collect goods, that they cannot wake up, that they cannot move, that they want to stay closer to their parents because it's just so cold. And you might not think it's actually that cold, but it is, as you already said it, but I want people to imagine that you're sleeping in a forest, in a structure, very simple structure made out of bamboo and covered with plastic. And that the only thing that you have between your body and the humid soil is plastic again. So like that 10 degrees Celsius or 50 degrees Fahrenheit can be actually really, really cold.
Yeah, it is. It's just awful what this community is going through. How is Save the Children helping them? What are you doing to lessen these awful conditions they're enduring?
Yeah, we're helping them across all sectors, and I'm going to go in a bit, but I want to focus first on what we're doing regarding what we call winterization. So we're distributing 7,000 winter kits to help 30,000 most vulnerable families. These winter kits contain mattresses, blankets, gloves, pullovers, so the most basic equipment for children and their families to actually stay a bit warm in winter. And for the other responses, we're working across different sectors on health and nutrition, and we're also distributing food baskets. And we're establishing, already we have established over 30 child-friendly spaces where children actually can have a chance to be children again, to play, to relax, to have some counseling in case they need it, and just like to be child again.
Yeah, which is so desperately needed. I mean, the concern is with winter coming in, with the temperatures dropping, kids not being warm enough, that they're going to fall ill, that there's going to be an uptick in respiratory illnesses. I mean, given that the odds are high that there will be some kind of uptick in illnesses just because of the conditions they're in, I mean, are people in place to help to meet that health need if it should so arise?
Yeah, we are deploying large teams on the health sector. We have something called emergency health unit, and we have established already seven health centers, and we're going to establish two more. So in total, we're planning for nine. We're deploying more people. We're training more people here. A lot of Bangladeshi nationals, but of course the needs are huge, and we need more resources. We need more funding. We need the support from the international community to be able to meet all these massive needs.
You know, as we talk about winter coming and the conditions, we know that the Bangladeshi government is making plans to move the Rohingya to a low-lying uninhabited island, which, as I understand it, is also prone to flooding. I mean, what would such a location mean for these families, for these people?
Well, Save the Children does not support the movement to the island because it's, as you said, it could get flooded. So there are still discussions going over there, and we're going to try to keep the Rohingya refugee safe in a piece of land that is actually safe for them. Because otherwise, it could actually be much more vulnerable.
What is your greatest concern as we look ahead, as the temperatures drop? What's your greatest fear here?
One of the greatest fears is just getting more children ill. A lot of children actually are malnourished. So for children under 5, 1/4, so 1 in each 4 children under 5 are malnourished. So when this is the case, the bodies are much more prone to any disease. So with malnourished children and the temperatures dropping, we are afraid that there will be a rise in respiratory tract infections and other diseases, because children are so vulnerable to anything, that anything could happen to them in terms of health.
Yeah, there's a lot to be worried about. But you know, thank you for making time to speak to us and for giving us an update on conditions there in Cox's Bazar. Beatriz Ochoa, thank you so much.
Thank you.